Hi, I'm a learning advisor at James Cook University, and today I am going to be sharing with you a strategy for taking critical notes. It's one of the most powerful strategies that you can use as you're going through your studies, regardless of the year or the task that you need to do. So today we're going to connect and check in with how we feel in terms of confidence and competence for taking critical notes. We're going to look at what successful students do and also explore a real practical strategy to implement to help you with your critical writing. We're going to explore student voices and frequently asked questions about critical writing and give you an opportunity to think about what action you'll take as a result of participating today. So checking in now, have a look at the emojis below or on your screen and think of one or identify with one that describes how confident you're feeling or how competent you're feeling about critical note taking. Is it dread? Is it no confidence? Are you completely and highly confident? Well, we're going to check back in and see how the strategy that we explore today helps you with your confidence and your competence. So today's purpose really is to enable you to look at a quick, fast strategy that will save you hours of your time as you go about taking notes. It could be from your weekly readings, it could be in lectures, or it could actually be as you're preparing and putting together scholarly sources and evidence for an assignment. So you can have one of your subject readings on hand today to help you with this process. If you need to pause the video now, go off and grab one of your key weekly readings and have it ready for a little later on in this session. So what is this critical note-taking strategy that's so powerful? Well, you can find this strategy with so many others at the link provided on the slide today. But basically, it is a strategy that a lot of students use to develop a really clear sense of academic self-confidence, to invest time on task and meaningful time on task, as well as engaging in an active strategy instead of taking passive role in the learning process, actively doing, because that's where you retain information and make more lead to more synthesis of ideas. So today we're going to learn critical note-taking strategies and one power strategy in particular. And the challenge really is this. A lot of students talk about how challenging taking critical notes are. We think that note-taking can be as simple as writing notes from left to right on your paper. But when academics and lecturers give you feedback on your assignments, like there needs to be more synthesis, you need to make rich connections and form relationships between ideas, there are strategies that we can employ in our study habits to read and take notes more effectively. Some students talk about the struggle with writing assignments, and half of the battle can be won by taking really clear, concise, effective, and critical notes. And sometimes students share with the learning advisors that you could be reading all of the notes that you need to for a week or an assignment, and you're struggling to make sense of what you're reading and retain it for that matter. So I'm going to share with you a strategy that helps you familiarize yourself with a text, even if it's a completely new text that you know nothing about. So that's by developing an overview, skimming and scanning through the text and looking for key clues. The next part of effective note-taking and reading is describing what the text does. So that can be done through defining key terms, looking for evidence in the text and drawing conclusions, or looking for implications of what it all means. That's the interpretation. So it's what's the intent, who is included, excluded, what are the limitations, and what's the overall meaning of the text. Critical readers and critical writers and critical note takers employ all of these strategies in their work and often get the best possible marks as a result. So the Learning Centre has compiled, along with some other academics and scholars, a really simple downloadable template for you to use. You can print it out or you can use it online or on your computer to help you make sense of and organize your notes and your thinking while you are reading. So it's a simple template broken up into three categories. There's some space for you at the top of this template to put the title of the reading, the publisher, the author, and the date so that you can draw on it and use it as a reference in your assignment later on. You can also use this template weekly as you're making sense of the readings that are prescribed or even in your lectures. So the three categories are based around those top skills that critical readers and writers and note takers employ. Familiarization. In this section, you can write down what the key points are from the article or what you're reading. And the largest section of this template is describing what you are reading with examples and evidence. You can even put the page number there. So you could draw on these as paraphrased text, a direct quote, or a summary in your assignments or in preparation for your study plan. The bottom space is employed for that. What are the take-home messages from what I'm reading? You know, what was the author's position? Is it in contrast with someone else? Are there limitations? How does this reading relate back to what I've been hearing, the key concepts and themes in my discipline and my course and my subject, and what will it help me reveal or understand as a result? All of these templates can be downloaded from the link at the bottom of your screen. So the critical reading strategy is a beautiful organizational framework and template for you to make sense and keep track of your thinking and your critical analysis. So let's actually have a look at a journal article and the kinds of key information that would help us find those three sections to familiarize ourselves with the key topic or the content, the examples with evidence, and the interpretation. So when you download from a database, perhaps a journal article, you will see that there is an article title. And the article title will give you a succinct overview of absolutely what this article is about. So the key words here are World Cafe in the context of Singapore. There's a subtitle, Creating a Learning Culture Through Dialogue. So it's about learning and it's about creating a culture of learning through a particular style of dialogue. Also on the journal article front cover, there is usually the authors. And you can see here that there is some credibility with Samantha Tam associated with a university and perhaps the other author associated with the whole concept itself. This gives the article credibility already that two key experts are actually putting together this article. And usually at the beginning of a journal article is an abstract. An abstract is usually 10 or so sentences which gives you a complete overview of the whole article. It's a powerful place to really dive in, skim and scan and pull out key ideas to get a sense of whether this article would be helpful for understanding your content area or preparing you for evidence and putting together your assignment. So, as we go into a journal article, there are some other parts that are important to explore. This is just a couple of paragraphs that I've taken a screenshot from the same article. But as you're filling out one of those scholarly templates for note-taking, critical note-taking, you can sit with the whole article beside you and look for three things in every single paragraph to help you make sense of what you are reading. The very first thing is the topic sentence. It's usually the first sentence of every paragraph, and it will give you an overview of what the topic is or the focus of the topic for that paragraph. So here you can see that in this paragraph, it's the cafe process. It's talking about and it will cover what actually happens in the process of the cafe style of dialogue. So as a critical reader, you can dive straight in and find the topic sentences to identify, highlight, or take key notes of one or two words, which is the essence of that paragraph focus. Another aspect of a paragraph, and it's usually in the middle of a paragraph, is where an explanation or evidence is provided on that topic. So We can usually tell by evidence, where evidence is rather, because there is references or in-text citations. You can see author and date system reveals that there is an idea here that comes from Brown 2001 and 2002. Now, this is where we could pull out an aspect that Brown has said and put it on that scholarly note-taking template as an example or evidence of the CAFE process, or whatever the topic is in your paragraph. Another key sentence to be exploring in each paragraph is the concluding sentence. This gives a summary of the key idea, so it should protrude with a CAFE process summary, a concluding sentence, and it might even link to what idea is coming up next in the following paragraph. So, they are three key ingredients to be going focused in on while you're taking critical notes. Instead of reading everything from front to back and spending hours of your life on one reading, be strategic. Go looking for these key ingredients and have the scholarly note-taking template beside you so that you can pull out these key ideas from topic sentences, explanation and evidence sentences, and concluding sentences so that you have your own concrete example. And you're being very active in the process. Imagine a bundle of those critical note-taking templates bound together to come out so that you can look for evidence to include in your assignment and back up a thesis or a topic that you are exploring. Now, I guess it's over to you. But before I ask you to do something today with one of your very own readings, I want to explore for a very brief moment another really important part of a journal article or what you're reading that will help you being critical of what you are reading. It's the reference list. It's usually at the back of a book, the back of a chapter, or at the back of the journal article itself. Now, if there was only one or two references, I would be quite concerned that it may not be well researched enough. So there's a few here. There's roughly about five or six references, which is not a bad number, but usually there may be more if it's a longer journal article. You can have a look at the affiliations of who has contributed in terms of the ideas that have been integrated into the article, but it is also a wonderful place because if there was an idea in the article that might be handy for your assignment, you can go to additional sources from the reference list in this one reading to read further and look at exploring more angles. So now that you have seen a few key elements to pull out and explore and interrogate for critical note-taking, let's go to an example for you. So hopefully you may already have a journal article or one of your prescribed readings for this subject that you're currently enrolled in, and all you need to do is actually pause the video on this next slide or download one of the templates for yourself. Sit with the reading and find those key ingredients that we've just explored. You can stop and start this webinar, go backwards and forwards until you find all of the key aspects. So the title, also the main points discussed, look in the abstract for that. Description, go into the middle of the paragraphs for supporting evidence there. Don't forget to include the page numbers so you can draw on it easily if you were going to use a direct quote, paraphrase, or summarize for your up and coming assignment. And spend time with the interpretation. Are there any other readings that link to this idea or follow on from this idea or fill in gaps that may be present in that particular article? So I hope this strategy has ignited a little bit of confidence and competence about something that you can do right now to up-level your note-taking skills and be really organized with how you collate all of your critical notes together. So let's just look now briefly at some top tips from real students. In the past, students have come to the Learning Center because they have so many notes and they're not really sure what bits to use in an assignment. And when we show them the scholarly note-taking template, they get really excited about how they can really categorize their thinking, identify key concepts before they dive in and reread things six times. So their advice from real students is use the template. It will keep you sane and on track and focused. Another really great tip that a lot of students in the third and final years of study have talked about is saving some of these great critical note-taking templates across the degree, because you won't know when you might want to draw on that body of research again. So think of a system for keeping it all safe, whether it's online, a hard copy, or using a critical note-taking app like Evernote. Now, I see that there are some questions in the chat window, so let me just touch on those and check in and see what questions students have about critical note-taking. How do I locate the critical note-taking template? Great that you've asked that question. The link is embedded in this webinar, but you can also access the critical note-taking template from the Writing LibGuide on the library page at JCU. If you get stuck, a great thing to do is ask a learning advisor or a peer advisor, and you can simply do that by emailing learning@jcu.edu.au, whether you're studying internally or externally or at a distance. The learning desk is located on the Townsville and Cairns campus, and you can drop in there for a short, sharp question or some support with one of your assignments. So now think back to all that we've covered in this webinar today, and I want you to check in again. What is the level of confidence that you feel with critical note-taking? And do you think you could use this critical note-taking template to help you make critical notes of what you're reading? I'll leave that ball in your court. And there's one more question I want to ask you today, and that is, what is the one thing you'll do as a result of watching this webinar? I'm hoping that it's centered around looking for that template or even creating your own so that you can be really organized with the notes that you take and save hours of your life. Now, the only last thing to say today is, if you would like to stay connected, jump onto the Learning Centre Facebook page and follow our tips and all of the workshops we have on offer and short courses. As well as that, think about how you can access online resources. There is a gamut of them available through the Learning Centre website. And don't forget, you can always send us an email, ask us a question, or book in for a consultation with the learning advisor by simply emailing learning@jcu.edu.au. If you like this video, thank you. I'd love to hear some great feedback. Definitely send us an email. But if you want more, keep following the webinar series, because in the next webinar, we're going to be looking at planning an assignment from the due date all the way back to unpacking the essay question from our last video. So I look forward to seeing you in the next video.